I am saying I do not know what equation this represents, but whatever it represents, okay, whatever it represents, it has to pass through the intersection of this, these two planes. That means it has to pass through this line. Now passing through this line, you understand, passing through this line, it could be a wavy structure like that. Many things can pass. It can be a cylinder which can pass. No, I have a cylinder which passes like that, and this becomes its one of the edges. So that's why I am saying whatever this represents, I do not know yet. Yet I do not know, but one thing I am very, very sure, whatever it is, it has to pass through this line and all the points of this line, not one. Why? Because whatever point lies on the intersection of this, it always satisfies this. So it is not that halfway it will pass and then it decides to break away. No. You understand that theory? You have to understand this. Whatever this represents, I am not sure yet. That we will now explore. Okay. But I am sure about one thing, that it has to pass, since all those points which lie on this and this also lie on this, so this has to pass through the intersection of this, these two. Doubts, then ask me. If you do not have faith on the equation, you will never be able to apply it, never ever. You're sure? You're convinced? About this statement, you're convinced? All of you?
No.
Try to think. What I'm trying to say, I do not know what this represents. But T are all those vectors which lie on this, the intersection of this, which I know to be a line. That is, I'm sure about. That this is a line. This is a straight line. Okay? Now, if this is a straight line, and all the T's lie here, then T lies on this also. Because I have done nothing. I have done what? Two things were equal. A was equal to B. C was equal to D. I am just saying A plus C. I am saying A is equal to B. C is equal to D. So I am just saying A plus C is equal to B plus D. That's all. That's all I have done. Or I will say that A plus lambda C is equal to B plus lambda D. I'm not wrong. This is a basic algebraic operation that I have done on the LHS, corresponding LHS and corresponding RHS. That's all. This has to be understood by you. Okay? This has to be understood by you. This has to be understood by you. Okay. Now we'll explore what is this. After all, what is this? So this is R comes common, and due to the distributive property, I can say it is something like this. You understood? T is all those points which lie on it. Whatever lies on it, it lies on this also, because it satisfies this. So whatever this represents has to pass through all the points of intersection of the two planes, that means through this line. Now this becomes what? This is some vector n, right? I say together this becomes a vector, something, not a unit vector any longer, and this is some distance d. Something d, and what does it look like? This is the equation of a plane. It's back to the plane. The moment I divide it by n, this becomes r dot n cap is equal to d. That's all.
You get that? So I come to a conclusion that this represents what? Equation of a plane but passes through the intersection of two given planes. So it may be something like this.
So maybe looks like a plane, another plane. The green one looks like a plane. I am saying that this represents one of these, maybe the third one. Maine banaya usko, aaya nahi hai. What I'm trying to say, it is also a plane. It looks like a plane. The equation looks like a plane. I am saying that it may be one of these planes. It represents all the infinite planes. If you start varying the value of lambda, okay, it will give you all the planes that will pass through this. All. So what do? You are given two planes. So there will be infinite planes that will be passing through the intersection of these planes. Now there will be one more condition that you will be looking for the plane to be unique. So maybe it passes through some point, or it is perpendicular to some other plane, or it is perpendicular to some other vector. This kind of one more condition has to come in so that the value of lambda gets fixed. The moment it gets fixed, the plane becomes unique. Otherwise, you are left with infinite number of planes whose equation is something like this. Okay?
So
capital N is this. N1 cap plus lambda N2 cap. मैं ना वो कर रहा हूँ कि ये है कि आफ्टर ऑल किस चीज को रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं. ये भी तो हो सकता है कि ये दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ कोन, बट नो, इट इज समथिंग फेमिलियर टू अस. इट इज आर डॉट अ वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू अ स्केलर. दैट इज द वेक्टर, द इक्वेशन ऑफ अ प्लेन. आर डॉट अ वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू अ स्केलर इज द इक्वेशन टू अ प्लेन. डू वी गेट दैट? सो दिस थिंग, this represents the equation of a plane passing through the intersection of two planes, these two. Okay, it is equation of the planes passing through the intersection of R dot N1 cap is equal to D1 and R dot N2 cap is equal to D2. We get the point?
Yes.
Fine. Okay. What is the Cartesian form of it? Becomes a bit difficult for you people if you are using a pen, because the moment I'll erase this, it immediately becomes that this overlaps on that and looks like planes, right? If you do not erase that line, then it will create problems. That's how a brilliant software is put inside your mind. It immediately starts comprehending things from photographs automatically. Mm-hmm.